But you hope they're okay. They just need to come forward and fess up to what happened.
A car is in custody, but a criminal is still on the loose. Tonight, Cape Coral police are searching for the driver who crashed their car into a power pole just feet from the Cape Coral Parkway bridge. The accident shut down all Fort Myers-bound traffic for almost 8 hours. Multiple homes and businesses were left without power in the area. NBC2's Victoria Reslow is speaking with a witness who heard the crash. Victoria?
In the police report that we got late today, police say that that car came flying down the road, driving erratically at a high rate of speed before careening right into this power pole at the corner of Waikiki Drive. Now, almost 24 hours later, you can still see some of that debris lying here in the grass. Crash?
Just a big bang.
Turned crime scene.
And the power went.
Craig Schwartz watched from his apartment as Cape Coral police rushed to the crash scene on Cape Coral Parkway East just before midnight Sunday.
Massive damage. You got to wonder, even with a seatbelt, how anybody would walk away from that.
The driver of this Mercedes-Benz fled the scene after splitting this 45-foot power pole into three pieces, leaving dozens in darkness.
It was just like a total blackout over here.
Schwartz's neighbor got stuck in the elevator when the power went out.
He was stuck in there for about an hour and a half, and there's a safety to free them out. The fire department came.
The crash scene sent drivers searching for ways to get to the other side of the bridge, leaving many at a standstill.
Eastbound was a parking lot, and with 1,000 cars on the road, all standing still, there was nowhere to go.
Others, like publishing business The Home Mag, had to completely reroute their employees and operations.
Internet connectivity, phone, it's vital, and we didn't have any of that.
And tonight, while the lights are back on, police are still in the dark, searching for a suspect.
I can't fathom to understand what goes through somebody's mind when they leave their vehicle. I mean, you might as well leave your driver's license.
The Mercedes is in police storage at Cape Coral Car Care. Now, if you saw anything or think you know anything about this crash, you're asked to call Cape Coral Police. I'm live in Cape Coral tonight, Victoria Reslow, NBC2. If you're